Hello, my name is Christoph Timm, and I'm Business Area Manager for Environmental Engineering at HUESKER Synthetic. In this videocast, I'm going to introduce our active geocomposites to you. One key issue in the field of environmental engineering at present concerns the handling of anthropogenic pollutants. These are contaminants which were released into the environment by human activities. The substances in question range from diclofenac, used in painkillers and gels, and pesticides, to the persistent organic pollutants, POPs, banned under the Stockholm Convention of the 22nd of May 2001. Since this treaty was signed, the original list of 12 POPs, the so-called Dirty Dozen, has been extended to include some 26 toxic chemicals. Among these are polychlorinated biphenyls, PCBs, and polychlorinated dibenzofurans, PCDFs. Pollutants find their way into the ecosystem via diverse routes. One pathway is through traditional three-stage sewage plants, that are unable to remove all contaminants from municipal, industrial, or hospital wastewater. Another pathway are diffuse sources of pollution, including agriculture and infrastructure, as well as precipitation. Contaminated sites comprise a third category. Here, sometimes due to a lack of knowledge of the potential risks, pollutants have managed to enter the environment after accidents or through inappropriate storage. In Germany alone, the number of cases of contaminated sites and suspected contaminated sites is estimated at around 320,000. The relevant sites are gradually being recorded, categorized, and remediated by various measures according to their particular on-site situation and requirements. Active geocomposites offer a new method for both contaminated site remediation and the prevention of pollutant migration directly at the point of entry. As their core constituent, these mat systems incorporate active materials that are capable of binding contaminants. In their original form, these materials are not easy to integrate into construction works because they are granular and difficult to install, or because they are unable to withstand environmental conditions, for example, due to their lack of stability. By combining the binding capacity of the active substances with the robustness of geotextiles, active geocomposites are purpose-designed to remedy this disadvantage. The first active substance which I will present is the oil-absorbing polymer. It captures both oils and oil-based products, such as petrol, diesel, and kerosene. By means of absorption, though permanently binding oil, the polymer still allows the permeation of water. This makes it particularly suitable, among other things, for the separation of oil/water emulsions. When the active polymer layer is fully saturated, water permeability will be reduced to zero. Then this immediately indicates that the binding capacity has been exhausted. In Germany, this geocomposite is listed on the list of successfully tested oil and chemical binders issued by the German Watchdog Association, GOC. Depending on the thickness of the active layer, the geotextile composite is able to bind up to 7.3 litres per square metre oil. The product can be used in track beds, maintenance areas, as an oil barrier in water, and in many other applications as a means of preventing oil pollution directly at source. Activated carbon as a further active substance is used as an adsorption agent in a wide range of contemporary applications. These range from drinking and wastewater treatment to the chemical industry. Activated carbon is able to bind a wide variety of contaminants and has a capacity of up to 2,000 milligrams per gram. The material's binding properties result from its extremely large inner surface area. The surface area offered by 5 grams of activated carbon can sometimes equal that of a football pitch, for example. This is due to the highly porous carbon microstructure, which exhibits three distinct types of pores: macropores, mesopores, and micropores. The percentage distribution of these different pore types essentially depends on the starting material used for activated carbon manufacture. Typical starting materials include wood, coal, and coconut shell. Of these three, wood produces the coarsest and coconut shell the finest pores. The resulting resulting microstructure has a decisive influence on the binding performance for various pollutants. Hence, preliminary testing is often advisable as a means of singling out the most suitable activated carbon product for a particular application. Activated carbon can be used for contaminated site remediation, for example, to cap contaminated sediments in water bodies, as well as for landfill construction, transport routes, sludge lagoon capping, and much more. The active material, natural calcium phosphate, binds a variety of heavy metals, such as lead, uranium, cadmium, and zinc. The heavy metals form crystals on the surface of the active substance. These are very stable and remain insoluble under normal conditions. Natural calcium phosphate thus serves to prevent the migration of heavy metals into the environment. Apart from binding heavy metals, the material also acts as a buffer to ensure a pH value of 7 in its immediate environment. Applications of natural calcium phosphate-based active geocomposites include the storage of heavy metal contaminated soils, contaminated site remediation, the prevention of groundwater pollution at source, and landfill construction. The three active materials, the active geocomposites that I have described, already cover a wide range of applications for the management of anthropogenic environmental pollution. The key feature of the TectoSeal active product family lies in the customized configuration of products in response to site-specific requirements. This applies not only to the active materials, but also to the specified geotextiles. Here, in delivering solutions to particular demands, HUESKER can draw on its full range of geotextile products. I hope that this presentation has captured your interest. Should you wish to know more about the technical details and HUESKER solutions, then please take a look at our website or contact us directly. We look forward to providing you with advice and support.